everyone. Welcome to Gospel Music USA, your home on the television for great Southern gospel music. My name is Danny Jones. I'm with Singing News Magazine.
I'm Karen Peck Gooch with Karen Peck and New River.
And I'm Mike Lefevre with the Lefevre Quartet. And we are thrilled that you have joined us today because, as usual, we have some fantastic music.
Right. And as usual, Karen is more excited about today's program than any other program that she's
really
been excited
am.
About.
I will say this. Wes Hampton is one of my favorite singers, but he's also one of my favorite, all-time favorite people. And you're going to be able to get to know him more today as well and to hear great music from Wes.
Right. As a matter of fact, let's let Wes do what he does best. Ladies and gentlemen, say hello to Wes Hampton.
I'm not gonna worry, I'm not gonna fret. I'm not gonna speculate or contemplate what hasn't happened yet. I'm not gonna worry, He's got the whole thing in His hands. I won't let it haunt me, I won't let it win. I'm not gonna cause He's got the whole thing in His hand. Well, maybe lately I've started to resign. So here it goes, God only knows it might just ease my mind. I'm not gonna worry, I'm not gonna fret. I'm just gonna wait and see, and in between give thanks for what I get. I live in the moment. He's got the whole thing in His hands.
Yes, it does.
And maybe lately I've started to resign. So here it goes, God only knows it might just ease my mind. I'm not gonna worry, I'm not gonna fret. I'm not gonna speculate or contemplate what hasn't happened yet. I'm not gonna worry, cause He's got the whole thing in His hand. He's got the whole thing in His hand. He's got the whole thing.
You believe that? My wife is a marriage and family therapist, and she has a lot of clients come in, as you can imagine, and they find themselves in difficult positions in their lives. And sometimes it's choices that they have made. Sometimes it's choices that they have not made. Sometimes in life, we find ourselves in a situation where it is in our control. And sometimes we find ourselves in a situation where it's out of our control. But a question that she asks all of her clients is this right here: do you want to be well? And that is a question that even Jesus asked. Are you ready to change your life circumstances and give it up for Jesus?
Waiting there for 38 years, cried so long he ran out of tears. Just a worn out man looking for a healing hand. Then one day his chance came along, a healing man who could make him strong. And then he caught his eyes, but his question took him by surprise. Do you want to be well? Really want to be well? Are you willing to take up your mat and help yourself? Do you want to be free? Really want to be free? If you want to be healed and whole, you gotta want to be well. ever try to fix yourself? And every time you got up, you fell, and then you wobble there, drowning in your own despair. Have you gotten used to the chains? Are you so attached to the pain? You're afraid to part. Ask the man for a brand new heart. Do you want to be where? Really want to be where? But are you willing to take up your mat and help yourself? Do you wanna be free? Really wanna be free? If you wanna be healed and whole, you gotta wanna be well. Mm-hmm. There's a better life that's waiting just for you. There's are you willing to take up your mat and help yourself? Do you want to be free? Really want to be free? If you want to be healed and whole, you gotta want to be well. Yes, if you want to be healed and whole, you gotta wanna be well.
Welcome back to Gospel Music USA. Our guest today is Wes Hampton. And Karen,
yes,
you have just absolutely been mesmerized today, haven't you?
Well, I have. And even we have a couple of ladies in the audience today here in the studio that are going, oh, you got to see him close up.
Right.
And
right.
Got to hug
Wes.
You're
very disappointed, by the way.
No.
But let me just share with everybody, the excitement is not necessarily because Wes is here. It's because his cookbook is here. That's why
is here.
There is a lot of excitement going on in the room right now. All right, Karen, go ahead.
Well, the name of it is Recipes, and I think that is so brilliant. I mean,
thank
that's
you.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Your favorite thing in here.
Oh.
You cook a lot.
I cook a lot.
I follow you on Instagram, by the way.
I'll follow you on Instagram.
Yay.
Instagram buddies.
But I love to see the pictures.
No.
It really,
okay.
Yeah.
I'm going to hold
are
this
y'all
up.
On Instagram?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. I'll
yes.
follow you both, I
okay.
promise. Okay.
I'll be looking
so,
for that today.
So the name was something that I came up with years ago. I said, if I ever do a cookbook, I'm calling it Recipes. It's just funny and
it's
people remember
perfect.
It.
Perfect, yes.
So, I don't know. It depends on what mood I'm in, if I'm trying to be good with my diet or,
yeah.
or if I don't care. Mm-hmm. Then there's a garlic potato soup that is ridiculous. It's creamy. You put cream in it and...
Oh.
Bacon and tons of garlic, and it's
bad.
That sounds
so good right
now.
But
it's so great. And then there's stuff like homemade pasta. You can make your own pasta. It's fabulous.
Is that hard to do? I see it on TV.
No, it's very easy. It's very easy.
Okay.
And you can do it in a food processor.
Oh, wow.
So you see the people on TV that make the little, you know, mound of flour, and they burger it with their hands. No, that's too much work.
Right.
Put in a food processor, pulse, and then roll
that's
it out.
Awesome.
It's
you know,
awesome.
I do that. I get it and say, wife.
Well, the thing is, you come up with your own recipes too, don't you?
Yeah, I do. I try
like
to.
Like you try things,
that's
and that's what's so awesome about this.
Yeah.
Everybody, especially all you ladies at home, you have got to get this cookbook Recipes.
Is this funny?
I know. It just felt funny, especially with this blonde accent.
Southern accent.
But Recipes on WesHampton.com.
That's right.
Yes.
Blonde accent. I'm trying to.
Like, it's
trying
a blonde. I think she meant blonde Southern accent.
Okay.
Right.
That makes better.
Accent.
Blonde.
Yeah. Country.
Yeah. Blonde country accent.
Hey, I grew up in that. Yeah. I grew up in West Tennessee.
But you live in Birmingham, Alabama,
I do
right?
I live in Birmingham now.
And Gaither Vocal Band. You've been there since 2005. Wow.
Right. Oh, you know, on another show, he alluded to a 7-week audition.
Yeah.
Now that's got to be a very stressful 2 months, basically.
It was very stressful.
Give us a little. mini tour of that 7 weeks?
Well, if you know Bill, if you work with Bill, you know that when he wants something, he kind of wants it right then. Mm-hmm. So he would send me tracks through email, say, hey, I want you to record the song. I want you to hear, I want to hear your voice in the song. So he was on the Gaither cruise, and he would have the office call me at home. Hey, Bill wants you to record a little as much. He wants you to record this song, this song. So I had to go to studio in Birmingham, record it, and then email the files to him on the ship.
It's Did crazy. You
yeah,
really?
And then I would drive back and forth to Nashville. I remember that the first time I went there, actually the first time was at Guy Penrod's house. That was, Bill kind of, Bill had Guy kind of fill me out to make sure I wasn't psycho or anything. Yeah. So, hey, let's go to Guy's house. We kill this guy and his family. You
know? Yeah, so, wow.
We go to Guy's house.
Wait, but he's got 9 kids. Is that right?
Or,
eight or
72
nine?
72 or something. Yes.
Yeah, 72.
There's
kids.
A lot of
no, eight kids.
Eight kids.
Okay.
One girl.
Okay.
One girl. So I went to his house. It was fabulous. We sang for 4 hours.
Wow.
Because he kept asking me if I knew songs. I said, yeah, I know that one. I know that one. I knew more than Marshall Hall knew, who was the baritone at the time.
Wow.
And that then led to more auditions of me going to Nashville. And the very first time I drove to Nashville to meet in the studio, Anthony Berger was there.
Wow.
And, I love him.
He played There Is a River, and we sang There Is a River. And I thought, Anthony Berger is playing for me.
Okay,
now
were
it was just so cool.
And were you nervous? Nervous?
I was nervous, but at the same time, I was put at ease because, you know, Russ Taff, you know Russ, he's just so precious. He's so sweet.
Yeah.
Everybody was so kind. So that's what made a big difference for me.
So I have a question. This was, went through my brain. When you were young and you were interested in gospel music, who did you see maybe besides the Gaithers and say, love this music?
Without a doubt, it was Steve Green. That was the one that my parents took me to see all the time. It was Steve Green.
People need the Lord.
Yeah. Oh, it's so great.
Oh,
so many wonderful
that.
Songs. And then Larnell Harris, I remember seeing Larnell many times. He's amazing.
Yes.
And then I was a big Michael Inglis fan, which I think everybody and their dog was in the 90s. But I never got to see Michael in concert. I never saw him in concert. So those are the big influences for me musically, but I would have to say Steve Green is definitely at the top.
That's awesome. You know, the thing is that I was thinking of there are so many young guys now that are thinking, they're saying that about you. And they are pattering themselves
set
after you.
Set your sights a little higher.
No, but this is the thing that I love so much about you, and it makes me cry because you are such the real deal. Everybody talks about, you've got a good name. You know, a good name is better than wealth and riches. You have not only got an incredible talent, but we know that God's called you. And I love the scripture in Revelation. It says, whatever doors God opens, no man can shut.
That's right.
And so the reason you went 7 weeks, you know, not knowing and kept, you know, singing songs, recording, and then it got to where you went to these places and you did it. You know, it's because God said, you're going to do this.
Yeah,
you know,
exactly
he
right.
gave you the courage and the strength and the talent to do it.
Yeah.
Amen.
We're going to show you what God has allowed West Hampton to do. Come back for more Gospel Music USA.
If you like gospel music, you're at the right place. You're watching Gospel Music USA, and our guest today is none other than the incredible singer, West Hampton. Here's some more from him.
Cherish the old rugged cross. my trophies at last I lay down, and I will cling to the old.
Praise to the Lord
doth prosper, thy work and defend thee. Surely his goodness and mercy here daily attend thee. Ponder anew what the Almighty can do, if with his love he befriend thee.
Thank you so much for being on the show today. And also a lot of you at home, we didn't touch on this earlier, but you are also, you have a wonderful family. You have four sons, a beautiful wife.
Yes.
So as sweet as he is, y'all, I'm telling you.
That's pretty sweet.
That's pretty sweet. And you need to get his cookbook, Recipes, right?
Absolutely, yes. Cook but, for your family.
That's right. But also, you also have projects of your own as well as the Gaither Vocal Band. But they can log on your website at
www.westhampton.com.
Wes, we are so glad you've been on the show today.
Thank you, Karen, so much.
I know all of you at home have enjoyed Wes being with us and to be able to hear your story. And you know what? You have a fabulous story. And you know, and I've said this before, but he has such an anointing on his life. I know you all love him as much as we do. And be sure that you check his website and go see him when he's in concert. See the Gaither Vocal Band when they're in concert as well. And we love Bill so much. And he's been so good to us. And you know, you've been with the Gaither Vocal Band since 2005. So you're a stable figure.
I'm like the old guy in the group.
Listen.
Who'd have thought?
There you go. Well, I think I'm a little older than you, but there you go.
You know, let's not talk about that.
We won't talk about that. We'll keep singing some more music. So thank you again.
Thank you, you're the best.
You're the best. We love you. I love you and appreciate you and your family. And y'all, join us again on Gospel Music USA. Go on Facebook and like our page and continue to pray for us. And hear some more music from Wes Hampton.
Here's an old Gaither Trio song some of you might not have ever heard before. It's one that we recorded, about 13 years ago.
Well, I've noticed something lately that I've never seen before. My neighbors are so thoughtful, and my family loves me more. Yes, there's music in the traffic, and there's laughter in the air. And little deeds of kindness everywhere. Yes, I feel excited like a kid the first warm day in May. Like something great is just about to happen any day. Oh, the grass and trees and sky look different. The people passing by are different. But could it be the difference is in me?
Now I just can't wait to find out what each day will have in store. The things that were important aren't important anymore.
Find out what I value are the things I can't replace.
A happy home and sunshine on its face.
The joy I feel in knowing I have chosen to do right. Oh, to know that all the past
difference is in me.
Yes, I do. The difference is in me.
Oh, the difference is in me. The difference is in me.